So today I want to talk to you about a subject that is really gross, but we've all got to deal with it, so let's talk about it. But first, I'd like to ask you to subscribe to my channel. Please make comments in the comments section below if you feel inclined, and let a colleague know about this if you find it useful and you think they would find it useful too. Okay, so the problem that all voice actors have to deal with at one time or another is phlegm. Pretty gross, but yeah, we all deal with it at one time or another. Even if you're not sick, this can be an issue. So for me, I have seasonal allergies. Things in my indoor environment will bother me if it's dust, mold, pollen, pet dander. There's lots of opportunities for you to get irritated and to have phlegm kick into motion and then get onto your vocal cords. So what you want to do is recognize the early signs. I know you're pretty sensitive to your voice to begin with, so you probably know when something bad is afoot. So if you feel like you got a little drainage going on, then you want to deal with it really quickly, and here's how. I like a combination of an over-the-counter non-drowsy antihistamine for a few days to keep things in check. Also, a neti pot with some sea salt. Natural sea salt has antibacterial properties in it that will help soothe and also stave off infection. So a neti pot with that, an antihistamine, and just keeping an eye on that, keeping it off your vocal cords to begin with. There's also an exercise, a companion blog post where I mention and I demonstrate an exercise on how you can get phlegm off your vocal cords if you're about to go into a session and you're kind of gunked up down there. So where does it come from? Well, I mentioned the things in the environment, the irritants that can cause it. Basically, when those pollutants, when you breathe them in, they go into your nasal cavity, up into your sinuses. The sinuses then produce mucus, which is a protectant, which is a sealant, a coating, to catch all those pollutants. And then once it's done with that mucus, it flushes it down the system, which happens to be your nasal cavity, your eustachian tubes that come from your ears, and it goes right down into your past your larynx. That instrument of ours is sitting right there in the midst of all this. So that's the process. And how do you stop it? Well, you want to live in as clean an environment as possible. You want to make sure you dust, vacuum, you know, have a nice healthy environment, keep yourself hydrated, and kick in with those preventative measures of antihistamine and sea salt flush of your sinuses when you feel that stuff happening. That should do it for you. That should keep it in check. Hope you enjoyed this. Please spread the word. If you like what you're seeing, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.